This is the last burning question. Yes, sir.
This is a question and a comment. My name is Woodie Lawson. I just graduated from Jackson State 2012. And this is a perspective. It's coming from perspective of a student. We have technology in place, Microsoft, smart boards, everything. I've been in classrooms where a lot of teachers don't understand the software. They don't understand what's there. So the comment is, as a student, it's discouraging. You know, you have other schools that are more advanced. These students are coming out. They know how to use this equipment and everything. They're familiar with it. And we're graduating against them. The question is, what are we doing in a proactive way to better prepare these teachers for the students that are to come so that they don't graduate the way that some of us have graduated?
Thank you. Well, but wait a minute, don't go away, because I want you to hear the answer. Thank you. That's a hard question for our speaker to answer, because he's a consultant and a person who's come in. But your point's well taken. The utilization of technology is unevenly distributed, not only among faculty, but among the community and young people at large. Some people come to class more readily available to and using the technology than others. But your point is a really good one. In the digital generation, more young people are coming more prepared to use multiple types of technology. You know, I'm old, you know, we didn't have a lot of stuff that you have. But I can tell you some of the things that are occurring on campus now. One, Dr. Blaine, and in the schools and colleges, there's really an attempt to provide education and training to faculty like me, who, you know, kind of the digital generation passed them. And so more faculty are engaged in learning these new sets of technology. And that's one thing, and that's really a good thing. We're engaging more of the students to serve us and learn from them and learn the ways that they use the technology. I think the app would be one example of how we're communicating to students. We found out that they might not read the email, but they'll use their app to get information. And so that's what was the reason behind the JSU app as well. The other part of it is, and you hit that as well, we have to equip the classroom so faculty can do their jobs. In other words, it's utilization of the technology, but it's having accessibility to the technology so that blend of learning how to use it and having it available works. But I can assure you that under this president and the rest of the faculty leaders, it was mentioned earlier, I think, from the chair of the Faculty Senate, that the request was made to provide some updated technology to the faculty. And I can assure you that your university is going to ensure that there's a technology-enriched environment, including wireless as well. Thank you.
So that's it.
I want to give a more direct answer to my frat brother's question. I'm Dr. Everett Niesman. I teach Shakespeare, Chaucer, and Milton here. And first, I want to thank Provost Mark Hardy and Robert Blaine. I was a member of this summer's QEP 4-week intensive. And instead of just answering his question from the podium, I'm going to give you an example. I created here a complete iBook in 4 weeks that breaks Shakespeare down into the big four: Hamlet, Macbeth, King Lear, and Othello. And it has 4 different sections for each, complete with student interaction, videos, learning devices. I learned what a widget was. So, and I've already rewritten and submitted my fall syllabus to Dr. Blaine that will utilize this new iBook that we were given in that process. So we're already off and running, frat. And one thing that is done for me, and I'll just share this with you because we like to know about changes in thinking. I'm usually a prompt person. Examine this, observe that. answer this. But what we learned to do and what we focused on with the iBooks is not the technology, but turning this iBook into a question mark. Getting, you know, asking students, what do you think about Hamlet? How would you approach Macbeth's ambition from your understanding of your world around you? So turning prompts into questions. So frat, we're in motion. We're doing it right now.
Amen.